Now we have calculated the BSFC. Now well, let us look at the mechanical efficiency. So mechanical efficiency BP by IP. We have calculated BP, but we don't know the IP. Okay. Now we have to calculate the IP based on the Mohr test. Okay. IP is equal to BP minus BP1 plus BP minus BP2 plus BP minus BP3 plus BP minus BP4. Where BP is when all cylinders are working. BP1, BP2, BP3, BP4 when the cylinder number 1, 2, 3, 4 respectively is cut off. Okay. Now we know the equation brake torque, brake load into torque arm is the torque is equal to T load into distance. Okay. Now substituting the value of this in the BP. BP is equal to 2 pi NT divided by 60. So 2 pi N is constant. Now the only thing is the torque arm length also is fixed. Only W1, W2, W3, W4. Those values will change here. So the equation is BP is equal to 2 pi N T1 divided by 60,000. So here 2 into pi into N is 2800 RPM. W1 is 110 into 0.37 divided by 60,000. That is BP1 is equal to 11.92 kilowatt. Similarly, W2. Here 2.2 torque 2 divided by 60,000. So 2 pi n is constant here. 2 pi n, that is 2000 into W2 is 107. Similarly, W3 is 104 in third equation for BP3. And fourth equation for BP4, W4 is 110. Rest all 2 pi n and divided by 60,000, these all remain constant. So you get the value of BP2 as 11.59. BP3 as 11.27 kilowatt and BP4 as 11.92 kilowatt. Now to find out BP, BP is equal to, sorry, IP is equal to BP, that is 17.35 when all are working, minus BP1, that is 11.92, plus 17.35 minus 11.59, BP2, that is BP minus BP3, BP minus BP4. So you get IP as 22.7 kilowatt. So mechanical efficiency is BP is 17.35 divided by IP is 22.7, that is 0.7643 or 76.43%. Now the last part is to find out the integrated mean effective pressure. Same, we will use the formula for IP. IP is equal to N Planck 100 by 60. Okay, so earlier equation we have used BP. So BP is equal to N Planck 100 by 60, but here that P is for BP it is brake mean effective pressure, for IP it is indicated mean effective pressure. Now we are going to find out indicated mean effective pressure. So IP is 22.7, N is 4 cylinders, L is 0.09, A is 5 by 4 into D square, 0.06 square, N is 2800 RPM, K is 1 by 2 and 100 by 60. So the mean effective pressure is 9.55 bar. Please understand this mean effective pressure of integrated power, that is 9.55 bar, should be higher than the brake mean effective pressure. Okay, that should be known because IP is more than BP. See here, brake mean effective pressure we calculated as 7.3. So indicated mean effective pressure will be higher than that. That is the IP. So you understood this is the last problem we are seeing on Mohr's test. I think very simple it is. You should know some relationships like torque is equal to load into distance. This is a standard relationship. Okay. Then BP is equal to 2 pi NT divided by 60,000. That is a second relationship we have used. And third is instead of IP, I can use BP also, and the same Planck relationship I can use this to find out the mean effective pressure. This we should know. Third one. And this brake thermal efficiency is equal to BP divided by mass of fuel into calorific value. Fourth one. And the fifth one is for specific fuel consumption. It should be fuel consumed in kg per hour per by BP. If it is BP, then it becomes brake specific fuel consumption. If I write IP here, then it becomes indicated specific fuel consumption. And the units is in kg per kilowatt hour. SFC is to develop 1 kilowatt hour by engine, how much fuel it is consumed in kgs. Okay. So these are the relationships. Please practice them so that you will have confidence in solving them. Okay. Thank you.